parked police car next to your colleague. You're out patrolling for signs of terrorist activity. You have a family waiting for you back at home. All seems normal. And then, all of a sudden, you and your partner are violently gunned down without warning. You have a... Imagine that you are killed instantly late and none of that mattered. December 20, 2014, officers Louis and Ramos of the New York City Police Department were killed. Now let's backtrack a bit. Let's say Louis and Ramos had been notified of their assailant, and their call was to go check it out. Upon arriving on the scene, Louis and Ramos had time to react to their assailant, drawing his weapon, giving them time to shoot him dead in self-defense. With that situation, there would be a public outcry. Protests for indictment of the two officers, leaving Louis and Ramos to be labeled murderers by the media. Thousands of people protested the death of Michael Brown in Ferguson, Missouri, a man who robbed a convenience store and then attacked a police officer, according to a St. Louis County grand jury. Yet two officers of the law dying in the line of duty, something as recent as December, has ceased to be reported by the media as much as Ferguson was. The media would have you believe that cops in America are all bad, that 100% of cops are bullies. Now, I am not saying that 100% of cops are in America are righteous, but the vast majority are hardworking Americans, just like the rest of us, who protect lives and save the individual freedoms that we hold most dear. Now, over 60 years ago, a man by the name of Herbert J. Taylor devised a four-pillar system still known today as the four-way test, a test, or rather, a code to live by that promotes good ethics in the world. I, myself, couldn't think of a better issue to apply the four-way test to as this sensitive topic. Is it the truth? Well, in order to do that, we have to look at what the truth is in this instance. According to 538.com, there are roughly 1,100 instances per year of a death in a police-civilian interaction. That's regardless of whether it was justifiable or the citizen took their own life or not. Not only that, but it doesn't count for the number of lives saved by police here in America every day. Now, in New York City, our nation's biggest city, with a whopping population of 8 million people, three people were killed throughout the course of 2014 in a police-civilian interaction. Now, with respect to those who lost their lives, I think that statistic is quite an accomplishment, considering crime has dropped nearly 80% in New York City alone. The truth is that the media, activists, and our own leaders want to strike out controversy over a few justifiable tragedies and divide our nation over them. Meanwhile, all this succeeds in doing is compromising the performance of the 99% of cops who are righteous, who fear that something they do could result in their name being broadcasted on live television for months on end. Put yourself in the shoes of Officer Darren Wilson, who shot Michael Brown. Your name has been broadcasted over every news source and bit of social media in America. Regardless of whether you were justified in what you did. Your name is the equivalent of dirt. The media has already labeled you a murderer before the facts have even come in. How could anyone look past that, live a normal life with that bad public publicity and death threats in the thousands and not go insane? It's no wonder Darren Wilson resigned his position as a patrolman. The truth is that cops are not the problem. It's the people exploiting these tragedies and dividing our nation who are the real problem and those dividing our country. The second pillar is whether this issue is fair to all concerned. Exploiting these tragedies and dividing our nation is not fair to anyone. It's not fair to the cops who risk their lives every day to protect and serve, and it's not fair to every American of every race and gender who have to listen to the propaganda being shoved down their throats about how the police are out to get them. The media acts almost like revolutionary advocates that promote unrest and distrust of those in uniform. They inflict their own personal beliefs in what they convey in articles and live broadcasts, resulting in a one-sided view into how cops are somehow the villains. The third pillar being whether this issue builds goodwill or better friendships. We cannot promote goodwill in our country if it is being torn apart by division, which really puts the quote, united we stand, divided we fall, respectively. We all live free under a flag of 50 stars, and police here in America are a necessary force for protecting us from complete anarchy. In order to promote goodwill, we first need to accept that self-defense and accidents are occurrences that happen every day in America and law enforcement. In no other profession are people scrutinized for doing their job like they are in law enforcement. We wouldn't condemn a teacher with protests and media attention for a student flunking their class. So why are we condemning cops for taking the necessary measures to protect others? Finally, will it build goodwill and better friendships? Oh, sorry. Will it be beneficial to all concerned? To benefit everyone, we need to rally together and not blame people who protect us every time something goes wrong. In order to benefit everyone, we first need to accept that police work in a profession where not everything is going to go right or wrong. Everything is a life or death situation. And, well, life or death situation. Everything is. It's bad. Police are scrutinized in our country. That's what I'm trying to say here. Police are scrutinized for doing their job. They are taking the necessary measures to protect others. And people end up dead in the process because they work in a field where not everything is going to go right or wrong. Now, I am not anti-criminal justice, and I am not cop-biased. I am simply, and without a doubt, pro-America. We all come from every corner of the earth. We are a nation of immigrants, coming together under a constitution that begins with, we the people. We are not a white state of America. We are not a black state of America. We are not a Latino or Asian state of America. We are the United States of America. Cops work in a profession where everything is a life or death situation. And they're going to take whatever measures they have to protect everyone, including themselves. So, my challenge is this. Why don't we use the four-way test and stop the scrutinization of our men and women in uniform, and instead, thank you for protecting your, mine, and our way to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Did you miss all of the things?
Yeah. I don't think that it's not the one.